approximating a definite integral using the midpoint method. So we have our function that we've been using on 1 to 5 with two subintervals. The definite integral is over here with the approximate answer here. So the midpoint method, what that does is you take the midpoints right here, the midpoint F values, and use that as your rectangle height n times by the delta x across here, and that gives you your rectangle area. It's not a left and it's not a right. You take the midpoint. The formula for the midpoint shows that you evaluate the function for each subinterval at the midpoint, the average of the left boundary over here and the right boundary of the subinterval. So in that case, it would be 1 plus 3 is 4 divided by 2 is 2. That'd be your midpoint of that first subinterval, and your height would be f of 2, which would be come out 2. Then you'd move on to your second subinterval, which is 3 to 5 over here, and realize that your midpoint is 3 plus 5 divided by 2. See, that's your midpoint of this subinterval, the average of your x boundaries for that subinterval. 3 plus 5 divided by 2 would be 4, and there you have that. Then you take the height there. See, that would be the height that you take. We're not taking the average of the f values. We're taking the function value one time at the average of the x's, the midpoint of the subinterval. That's why it's called the midpoint method. So we work that out over here. F at the midpoint of the first subinterval, f at the midpoint of the second subinterval, figures out to this, computes to, simplifies down to that, and it comes out to be 6, which compares pretty favorably to the actual true answer. It's only 0.4 something off. Certainly much better than the left and the right sum methods, because we're only using two subintervals there. Then we go down to a picture that shows what would happen with 8 subintervals. And here you have your subintervals. So you'd be evaluating at, for in this case, 0.25. That is to say, I made a mistake there, because this first boundary is your 1, and then the second one is 1.5. So the average of those two, computed over here, would be 1.25. And that would be the function value at 1.25 would be your height there. And that's how you would get the first area, the area being that function height times the delta x. And then you would do that for the 8 subintervals, and that would come out to be this number, which is very close, you know, but it's only 8 subintervals, so there's still some error there. And then we go on to 100 subintervals. As you can see on the picture here, looks very good, good fit. And you have your 6.437. The true is 6.4377, so it's a little bit off, but it's certainly converging faster than the left and right methods did, and comparable to the trapezoid.